Cursed energy is the cornerstone of the Jujutsu world. It flows through all humans, allowing them to hone it and form cursed techniques, but also their deepest fears and cursed spirits. In this way, cursed energy is a blessing and a curse from the heavens. However, what is given can be amplified at the expense of a person's body. Still, cursed energy would be present, until heaven strips a person of all cursed energy, repurposing it and makes a person an anomaly. An anomaly like Maki, Zenny. The Cursed Child arc gives an introduction to Maki's character, and she is presented to be quite headstrong and disrespectful. From the outset, she is aggressive towards Yuta and disrespects him. She quickly dissects Yuta, telling him that if he has no goal in mind at Jujutsu High, then he'd have a difficult time. Despite tensions, they are stationed on a mission together. Maki mentors Yuta about cursed spirits, and then the two are eaten. In the stomach of a cursed spirit, Maki is revealed to be injured, and they encounter two boys who ask for help, but Yuta doesn't believe he can. Maki asks Okkotsu why he came to Jujutsu High. She asks him what he expected and what he wanted when he chose to become a sorcerer. Yuta tells her that he wants to believe it's okay to keep living. Maki tells him he needs to keep exercising curses, and if he does, he'll find acceptance from others and understand his feelings. Later on, when Maki and Okkotsu are together, she tells him why Geto called her a failure. She reveals she cannot see curses naturally and her dream of becoming a grade 1 sorcerer. Okkotsu expresses his admiration of her and wants to help her. Maki rejects the notion and takes on this task alone. Still, she feels accepted by Okkotsu before coming face to face with Geto again and inevitably gets bodied. Maki is meant to serve as a guide for Yuta and provide him with a decent foil. Yuta is unsure and passive despite his immense power. Maki is assertive and sure of herself, but limited in her strength thanks to her low amounts of curse energy. Maki's body cannot innately resist curses, while Yuta can. Maki has to push Yuta to realize his purpose, and Yuta wishes to help Maki in her purpose. They reflect off of one another and help each other realize that their differences from other sorcerers are what makes them shine, allowing them to find solace in the fact that they have each other to rely on. With 1 year passing since her last appearance, the Goodwill event is meant to show how Maki has developed. She handles Miwa with ease, and all the higher grade sorcerers believe she should be promoted to grade 2. Unfortunately, Naobito hinders this because of Maki's goal to become the next Zenin clan family head, and he decides to make life difficult for both Maki and her sister Mai. Maki's choice to pursue freedom and forge her own path left Mai feeling abandoned. Maki couldn't allow herself to fall down the hole with her sister because of what she wanted to become. For Maki, giving up her chase for freedom was worse than abandoning her twin sister, but in her selfish pursuit towards this freedom, she became blind to what her sister wanted. Mai never wanted to be a sorcerer. She just wanted her sister to stay by her side like they promised. But Maki fearlessly walked down her own path that stretched far beyond Mai. Maki could not limit herself in mind when she already was weak in body. She wanted nothing except to become strong enough to claim her own self-worth, following her motivation from the previous arc and in her effort to prove herself, even if that meant leaving everything else behind. When Gojo is sealed, Nanami, Maki, and Naobito team up to go and save him. Both Nanami and Naobito tell Maki that it'd be best for her to go home. The fights to come require sorcerers grade 1 or higher, and Maki was at best a grade 2 sorcerer. She couldn't compare to either Nanami or Naobito, which is evident in their fight against Dagon. Naobito is able to rush Dagon multiple times and freeze him using his curse technique, with Nanami following up to keep Dagon on guard. On the other hand, Maki is placed on the back foot when trying to press her advantage against Dagon and is saved by Naobito. Maki fills the same role she did during the Goodwill event, which is being used as build-up for one of the main attractions during the current arc. Her fight with Dagon illustrates that perfectly as it mirrors her encounter with Hanami. She can't do anything with her first curse tool, Megumi gives her playful cloud which still doesn't make her relevant, someone new comes in and takes over the fight. For Hanami, it's Yuji and Todo. For Dagon, it's Toji. Both of these parties are compared to Maki in terms of physical ability and outperform her massively. Maki could not hope to defeat stronger cursed spirits, nor is she comparable to grade 1 sorcerers. So it begs the question, what good is she as a sorcerer if she can't handle curses that threaten events like Shibuya? Maki manages to survive becoming a well-done stake and joins up with Tengen to help make a plan for saving Gojo. Thanks to Megumi becoming the Zenin family head, Maki is able to gain access to its cursed tool warehouse. Before that, she informs Megumi of his newfound position along with his benefits, but he couldn't care less. Maki tells him that he has to do it because he has a domain, an inherited technique, and was favored by Gojo. Megumi still doesn't care and tells her that he could give her the position, but Maki rejects the idea and laments that she cannot make a place there for Mai. These feelings stem from her defeat in Shibuya. She was useless and still has yet to become a grade 1 sorcerer. Her goals were unfulfilled and she wasn't able to make a place for her sister. This underlying reason for becoming the Zenin family head is exactly why she cannot take the reins from Megumi. Maki is still a failure by her own standards. Still, she makes it to the warehouse and is met with her father. Maki faces off against Ogi and gets rolled, again highlighting her inability to compare to grade 1 sorcerers. Ogi drags both his daughters to a room filled with cursed spirits and roasts Maki, though Jogo did it better. Still, his speech matters. Ogi says heavenly restriction was nothing special, reinforcing Maki's perpetual state of inferiority in comparison to the average grade 1 sorcerer. He leaves the two of them to die, and Mai places her future within Maki. Twins are considered inauspicious, a fact Mai knew for a long time. Curse techniques treat twins as one being, so twins are two halves of one whole. Mai understands that in order for her sister to grow, she cannot hold her back, the same sentiment presented by their father. The roles reverse between the sisters as Maki begs for Mai to come back to her. Mai was content with giving up her life so Maki could become whole, so she leaves her sister with one final request: for her to destroy everything. This arc is a product of Maki's pursuit after her goals. She wanted to take over the Zenin clan to provide a place for Mai, so she pursued strength. However, she couldn't grow stronger because Mai never wanted to grow. Maki's story forces her to exchange one goal for another. She left her sister behind for strength, but her sister had to die for that strength. The clan she wanted to control ended up being destroyed by her. Her goals were dashed in her pursuit and became meaningless in the end. All she has left is the power she sought after for so long. Maki and Noritoshi enter the Sakurajima colony in an effort to put an end to the culling games. Maki's lack of cursed energy allows her to jump from colony to colony at will, and her monstrous strength is even more prominent now that she's at full power. A power that's put to the test against a cursed spirit in Aoya, who decides to put his Crocs into sports mode. Naoya quickly puts hands on Noritoshi and turns to face down Maki. Maki is incomplete. Her power couldn't match this new form of Naoya because she had become entangled with people. Maki sacrificed for her sister, sustained abuse from her clan, was too weak to fight when it truly mattered, and continuously compared herself to Toji. Maki failed to balance both her mind and body, so she grappled. She entangles herself with another person in order to find balance both in and outside of battle. To fight at her peak, she needed to understand everything about herself, which led up to that moment. Who was Maki and why does she continue to fight? Maki never understood what she truly wanted, and only through finding what that desire was, could she reach freedom. Maki wanted to be like everyone else when in reality she wanted to have something no one else could have, a strength and ability that made her special. Maki's character has always been in pursuit of freedom. Her strength plateaued, her clan limited her progression, and her lack of cursed energy made her worthless. Through this, Maki lost any semblance of balance. So until she could find balance, her true power was limited to its face value. Maki needed to understand her soul, which her katana best represented as its ability only activates when the wielder can observe souls. Once Maki came to understand her soul, and by extension, my soul, she broke free. Free of her inferiority, of cursed energy, and the Zenin clan. Maki was never Toji. She was free.